Good morning students all. Last class NEET problems 20 are completed. 21 you see. Page number 21. Question number 21. Page number 420. Okay, we'll finish some more 20 questions in this class. So in a small, if a small amount of antimony is added to a germanium cylinder, antimony will be pentavalent element. So it will becomes n-type semiconductor. N-type semiconductor means electrons, number of free electrons will be more than the holes in the semiconductor. 21st, it will be fourth option. Antimony will be pentavalent element. If you dope with pentavalent element, that will be n-type semiconductor. 22nd, simple and direct question. Forward biasing of the PN junction diode. First option will be correct for it. So what will happen in forward bias? Positive terminal is connected to P side, negative terminal is connected to N side, and depletion layer thickness will decrease. So first option will be correct. 23rd, you have to check all the options. In among the given, which will be in the forward bias? So here one diode is there like this. For A, what are the values here they gave is 10 volt, 5 volt. This is more than this, so it will be in forward bias. Second option, if you take, this will be zero ground, it will be, they gave minus 10 volt. So it is not in the forward bias. Minus 10 is less than zero, so it will be not in the forward bias. Third option, C, they gave one diode like this. What are the values given is minus 12, minus 5. Minus 12 is more than minus 5. So it will be in forward bias. D, if you check, 0 plus 5 is there, so it is not in the forward bias. So only A and C will be in the forward bias. So 23rd, it will be second option. Clear? Next. 24. What is that? See, 24. Pure silicon. Intrinsic semiconductor. After doping, NH value is given, NE value is what? So what they gave, see, pure silicon at 500K has equal number of NH and NE initially equal. By doping, NH is increased to 4.5 × 10^22. Then the doped holes are more, means it will be P-type semiconductor. So option will be in between 2 and 4. Initially, NI value will be 1.5 × 10^16. After doping, NH value becomes 4.5 × 10^22. What is the value of Ne? What is that type of semiconductor? So Ni square is equal to NhNe. So Ne is equal to Ni square by Nh. So 1.5 × 10^6² 4.5 × 10^22. Okay. So 1.5 means whole square means it will be 2.25 × 10^32. 4.5 × 10^22. That will be 1/2 × 10^9 means 0.5 × 10^9. Then Ne value will be 5 × 10^9 per meter cube. So Nh value is more than Ne, so it will be P-type semiconductor. So option for 24, it will be fourth option. Okay, since Nh greater than Ne, it becomes P-type semiconductor. Clear? Next, 25. What they are asking, see. Zener diode having breakdown voltage equal to 15 volt. So VZ is equal to 15 volt. And is used as a voltage regulator in the circuit as shown in the figure. The current through the diode is. So load resistance, how much they gave means 1 kilo ohm. IRL is equal to 1000 ohms. Okay. Series resistance they gave 250 ohms. Okay, what is the Zener current they are asking? We'll find circuit is like this. Na? Here Zener diode is there like this. Here applied voltage is 20 volt. Here load resistance is there 1 kilo ohm. Okay. And now this value is 250 ohms. Here potential drop will be 15 volt. Therefore potential drop across this will be 5 volt. Because total potential drop is 20. Here already 15 is there. So it will be 5 volt. So potential drop across the resistance will be 5 volt. IZ value will be how much? We'll find IL value how much. I is equal to VS by V, this one, V in by, no, VS by this value RS. So VS value will be 5 volt and RS value will be 250. So 1/50, 1/5 means 0.2. So this will be 20 milliamperes we will get I value. IL value will be VZ by RL. VZ value will be 15, RL value 1000. So this value 15 milliampere. I is equal to IL plus IZ. IZ is equal to what will happen? I minus IL, 20 minus 15. So this value will be 5 milliampere. So option for this 25, it will be fourth option. Clear? Next, 26. What we will get? What is that question? 26. Two ideal diodes are connected as shown in the figure. Now see, D1 will be in forward bias. D2 will be in reverse bias. So no current will pass through D2. Then what is the current through D1? Current in the circuit. I is equal to V by R. Applied voltage is how much they gave? 5. Across D1, 10 ohms is there. So this value will be 0.5 amperes. So 26, it will be fourth option. Next, 27C. What they are asking, 27. Common emitter transistor amplifier. Audio signal voltage across the collector resistance is 2 kilo ohm is 2 volt. Base resistance is 1 kilo ohm and the current amplification of the transistor is 100. Input signal voltage is how much? So little bit difficult. I will draw the circuit for this. So circuit will be like this. Common, this will be here, resistance will be there. Here, this will be input voltage, this will be output voltage. Okay, so what they gave, see. Output voltage, voltage across the collector is 2 volt means VO is equal to 2 volt. In the same manner, collector resistance, they gave 2 into 10 cube ohms. Base resistance, they gave 1 kilo ohm. This will be collector current, IC. Then, V in is how much? Using V out and RC value, you find IC value. From VO is equal to IC, RC. This is 2. This is IC, RC value 2 into 10 cube. Then we will get IC value is 1 by 10 cube, 10 power minus 3 amperes. IC value we got. From IC value you find IB value. from beta is equal to IC by IB. So what we will get, IB is equal to IC by beta 10 power minus 3. This current gain they gave, current amplification is 100. So it becomes 10 power minus 5 ampere. This resistance given, this current is given, you find this. V in is equal to IB into RB. IB value 10 power minus 5, RB value 1000. So we can write it as 10 milliamperes, volt. So this value 10 millivolt, 27, it will be fourth option for this. Next, 28. What they are asking, see, 28. Transfer characteristics, output voltage versus input voltage for base biased transistor in common emitter configuration is shown in the figure. If the transistor is used as a switch, okay, this 1 to 2 will be called as the cutoff region, saturated region. 3 to remaining will be called as the cutoff region. In that regions, this transistor will not be worked as a switch. So when transistor is used in cutoff region, in saturated region, like this you write, transistor can be used in cutoff region, in saturated region as a switch. Okay, so in regions 1 and 3, we can use it as a switch. Okay, 28, it will be second option. Next, 29. What they are asking, see, a simple ABC values you check. A0, B0, C0 first. Next, what they gave? A1, B0, C1. Next, A1, B1, C1. Next, A0, B1, C1. If it is like this, 0. If it is like this, 1. Okay? So then what will happen? What is this graph? What is this truth table? OR gate. So 29, it will be first option. Okay? Next, 30. What is that? See, 30. Carbon and silicon both have same lattice structure, having 4 bonding electrons in each. However, carbon is insulator, whereas silicon is intrinsic semiconductor. What is the reason? Means carbon electrons are in the second orbit, silicon electrons are in the free electrons are in the third orbit. 30, it will be third option. Next, 31. Input resistance of silicon transistor is 100 ohms. So, R in is equal to, how much they gave here is 100 ohms Ri. Next, what they gave, base current changed by 40 microampere. Delta Ib is equal to 40 microamperes. And change in the collector current, 2 milliamperes. Then transistor used as a common emitter amplifier with load resistance of 4 kilo ohms. Then voltage gain, AV is equal to beta into RL by RI. Beta value delta IC by delta IB, RL by RI. Delta IC 2 into 10 power minus 3. Delta IV 4 into 10 power minus 5. 40 into 10 power minus 6 means 4 into 10 power minus 5. This is 4 into 10 cube. RI value 100 means 10 square. See, this 4, 4 will cancels. 10 power cube, 10 power minus 3 will cancel. So this will be 2 into 10 cube. Okay, 2000. That will be the answer for it. So voltage gain will be 2000. So 31, it will be first option. Okay, next. C, 32. What they are asking. To get the output 1, what will be the inputs? See here, we did this problem, na? Same problem where we did. Question number 16 in the same NEET we did in the last class. So, second option will be the answer for it. Simple only, see. Here to get the output 1, definitely it should be 1. Then only output will be 1. So, this will be 1 when it is there. In the second option only, that will be 1. If this is 1, 0, output will be 1. When VT is 1, this will be 1 because AND gate. So, 32, it will be second option. Next, 33. What they are asking, see, 33. Common emitter amplifier having voltage gain G. The transistor used has transconductance 0.03 mho and current gain 25. If the above transistor is replaced with another one with transconductance 0.02 mho and current gain 20, what is the voltage gain? So, voltage gain, AV is equal to delta VC by delta Vb. We can write like this now. This delta Vc value will be RL into delta Ic by delta Vb. Delta Ic by delta Vb will be called transconductance. So this value is RL into GM. So relation between AV and GM both are proportionate. AV proportional to GM. A1 by A2 is equal to G1 by G2. Here what they gave, this is 25. Later it becomes 20. And G1 is 0.03. This we have to find. Okay, see 1 minute. So this is G by A2 is equal to, this value will be 0.03 by 0.02, means 3 by 2. A2 is equal to 2G by 3. So 33, it will be second option. Next, 34. What they are asking, see. What is the output of the logic gate? So, NAND gate is there. This will be AB bar. Okay. Now, just check. By taking the values, it will be easy for you. And here, applying the same inputs, so same NAND gate. What is this entire gate? That is the question. X they gave. Okay. AB values here, Y, X I am taking, Y you take. Already there X is there, na? 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. 0, 0, AND gate means 0, NAND gate means 1. 0, 1, AND gate means 0, NAND gate it will be 1. 10 also 1, 11 AND gate 1, NAND gate 0. Understanding? Now 11 output will be 1 if it is AND gate. Since it is NAND gate, this will be 0. So 0, 0. 0, 0, 0, NAND gate it will be 1. So finally, what is the gate we are getting here? See. It will be AND gate. So X is equal to AB. It will be an AND gate. So 34, it will be fourth option. Next, 35. What they are asking, see 35. In n-type semiconductor, which of the following statements are true? Check all the options. Fourth option will be the correct answer for it. Holes will be minority carriers. N-type semiconductor, first option what they gave? Holes are majority carriers. No, wrong. Electrons are majority carrier, second option. And trivalent atoms are dopants. That is not correct. Pentavalent elements are dopants. So second option is also wrong. Third option they gave, electrons are minority carriers. So that is also wrong. Holes will be minority carriers and pentavalent elements are dopants. That is correct. So 35, it will be fourth option. Next, 36 you see. What they are asking. The given graph represents the VI characteristics of a semiconductor device. Which of the following statement is correct? First statement will be correct. That graph will represent the solar cell, where A represents the open circuit voltage, B will represent the short circuit current. Okay? So 36, it will be first option. Next, 37, what is that? See, barrier potential of PN junction depends a type of semiconductor material, amount of doping, temperature, on all these factors. Barrier potential will depend. So 37, it will be fourth option. Next, 38. See here. One NOT gate is there. Another NOT gate is there. So here A, here B, this will be A bar, this will be B bar, these two inputs are connected like this. So it will be A bar plus B bar whole bar, according to De Morgan theorem, that will be equal to AB. So it will be AND gate. Okay, 38, it will be second option. Next, C, 39. What is that? C, PN junction, a square input signal of 10 volt is applied, then output across the RL will be. So what single diode na, it will behaves as a half wave rectifier. So upper halves will be rectified, lower halves will not be rectified. So output will be like this. So 0, 5 volt. It, for lower half, it will be in reverse bias. It won't conduct that. Actually, it is like this. Na? Minus 5, plus 5. This half wave will be rectified. Lower half will not be rectified. So 39, it will be fourth option. Clear? Last question. 40. What is that? See. What they are asking? 40. Diode is there. Diode is connected across the 100 ohms. Applied input is 3.5 volt. Barrier potential is 0.5. What is the current? I is equal to V by R. This value 3.5 applied, barrier potentially 0.5, you have to subtract, this value will be 100. So how much we will get here is, this is 3 by 100. (30 × 10⁻³) This will be 30 milliampere. So 40, it will be second option. Okay, with this we will stop the session now. Remaining problems will continue in the next session. We'll try to finish this chapter in the next session. Okay.